It turns out that Android 12 Beta 2 is pretty stacked with features, and so we're back with another dive into some we missed in our initial sweep. So let's get into it. Thanks for watching 9to5 Google here on YouTube. Remember to thumbs up, hit subscribe, and then tap the bell icon to be among the first to watch our upcoming videos. As with any of our deeper dives or follow-ups, it's worth noting that not all of these features in the Android 12 beta phase will be fully functional when they appear, but luckily there isn't too much here that you can't do. Some features do rely on a fresh install of the OS, so don't worry if you can't see them on your device just yet. We're sure they'll arrive in a future build. Although the double tap gesture has been in the works for over a year at this stage and wasn't working in previous betas, it's now live and working in Android 12 Beta 2, provided you have the right device. Tapping the back of your phone will perform a custom action, and you can customize this double tap to do things like take a screenshot, launch the Google Assistant, play or pause any currently playing media, access the recent apps menu, expand the notification shade, or launch an app on your device. At the moment, only those with the Pixel 5 appear to be able to activate the gesture regularly, but there are reports that some Pixel 4a 5G owners have been able to activate it too. It's also worth noting that you can use the double tap gesture system-wide, but it won't work when viewing the system settings menu, and some apps won't launch when require stronger taps is activated. One of the flagship features for Android 12 is widgets, and the start of that is the neat conversations widget that lets you jump into a conversation or message thread from the home screen. In Android 12 Beta 2, the widget is live for some people, but disappointingly, not for everyone out there. The conversations widget is able to tap into any ongoing message thread from different apps on your device, including SMS RCS from Google Messages, groups and individual messages in Telegram, and more on top. In Android 12 Beta 2, it defaults to showing the latest message received in the chat, still showing even when you've opened the message already. It'll open up on the default size, but nothing smaller. 2x1 just shows the profile picture and the person's name in the name of the message group. That said, this isn't available for everyone, so don't worry too much if you don't have it already. If you're a Pixel 4 owner or user, the former flagship and most powerful Pixel thus far is getting some love courtesy of a new face unlock animation in Beta 2. As the lock screen disappears, a wave of colour emits from the top of the display downward towards the bottom, signifying that the face unlock was just used. This effect is really subtle and quite hard to see, and it is pretty similar to some of the other animations found in Pixels with Android 12, including two similar waves that appear when the device is being charged. Just like the charging animations, this subtle change also follows your device wallpaper color settings as part of the Material U redesign. With Android 12 Beta 2, the Google Assistant has also learned how to open the power menu on your phone in return for taking over the power button. Effectively, you can ask the Google Assistant to power off and it will launch the power menu and allow you to restart or shut down your device. It would have been nice to actually fully shut down your phone using your voice, but at least opening the power menu fills the gap left by the Google Assistant taking over the lock button if you have Hold for Assistant activated. That said, if you don't want Hold for Assistant activated, you're just going to be able to use your phone power button as normal. The charging animations in Android have been on the receiving end of some tweaks since Beta 1, but Beta 2 refines them yet again. When plugged into a USB-C charge cable, the ripple effect that we saw previously is now more subtle and fades before reaching the top of your display. For wireless charging, the ring dots have been replaced with a simple wave of colour. The percentage remains, but now is noticeably larger. In tandem with Android 12's dynamic lighting on the lock screen, it's a nice effect that really is refined compared to what we've seen previously. Picture-in-picture mode is a popular feature, but with the Android 12 Beta 2 update, it's important that you might encounter a few slight issues when attempting to resize the floating player. The actual player now has rounded corners to mimic the more bubbly aesthetic that Android 12 has really lent into, and we can see this being pretty divisive from a user standpoint. The ability to drag a corner and resize the picture-in-picture window has also been dropped in favor of a double tap to enlarge gesture. When you do this, the player will just expand to the full width of your display. However, you can still use the pinch to resize the window option as you see fit, which might be the preferred activation method for many people anyway. So in combination with our first deep dive, that should be every single feature that we've found in Android 12 Beta 2 thus far. Be sure to go and check out the first part of this video so that you know exactly what is new here in Android 12 Beta 2. Oh, and if any of you out there are looking at our Android 12 wallpapers thinking, I'd love to get one of those, drop a like on this video, and if we hit 2,500, we'll share them in our appropriate 9to5 Google exclusive wallpaper folder. Sure, of course, on top of that, there might be some hidden options in Android 12 Beta 2 that we haven't seen or found evidence of yet, but for the most part, this is quite the overhaul so far. What is your new favourite feature or features that you've seen? Be sure to let us know down in the comment section below. But as always, this is Damien with 9to5 Google saying thanks for watching, and I will speak to you later.